Welcome to GVol's lesson on option Greeks. Today we're going to do a broad overview of the five basic option Greeks: Delta, Gamma, Theta, Vega, Rho. So far in our video series, when we've talked about the profitability of options, we've done so in terms of the value at expiration, not the value before expiration. The option Greeks help us understand how the expected value of options, or the theoretical pricing, is affected for changes in different variables. The first Greek of interest is called delta. Delta will tell us, for a $1 change in the underlying, what will be the effect on the value of the option, holding everything else constant. Meaning, if I have a 0.3 delta on my call stock option, a 1 point or $1 rally in the underlying will increase the value of my option by $30. We get $30 because it's 0.3 times 100 shares times the 1 point rally equals $30. For calls, delta is going to be positive. For puts, delta is going to be negative. When you buy a call, you will have a positive delta. When you sell a call, you will have a negative delta. When you buy a put, you will have a negative delta. And when you sell a put, you will have a positive delta. Our second Greek of interest is called gamma. Gamma is a second order derivative of delta. What this means is that as the underlying prices change, the value of the delta of the option also changes. By convention, gamma is also quoted in $1 increment terms. So if you have a gamma of 0.02, given our last example, the first dollar increased the option by 30 bucks, and then the second dollar rally in the underlying will increase it by 32 bucks. That differential from 30 to 32 in the delta is the gamma. If you buy options, you will always have a positive gamma, whether you buy a call or buy a put. And if you sell options, you will always have a negative gamma, whether you sell a call or sell a put. The beauty of being long gamma is that as the position goes in your favor, you get more and more exposure. And as it goes against you, you get less and less exposure. Let's see this with a call. If you own a call that has a delta of 30 and a gamma of 2, and let's just assume that gamma remains constant throughout this example, well then as the underlying rallies, your option will gain $30 for the first point, $32, then $34, so on and so forth. But as the underlying falls, you'll lose $30 for the first point, then $28, then $26. Gamma in this case is said to be working in your favor, your long gamma. Let's look at the same example with a put. If you own a put with a negative 30 delta and a gamma of 2, again, we'll hold gamma constant for simplicity, as the underlying rallies, you'll have less and less exposure. So the first rally in the underlying will lose you $30. The second point rally will lose you $28. The third, $26. So you get less and less exposure as the position is going against your put. Vice versa on the way down. The first point down will earn you $30. The second point will earn you $32, so on and so forth. You see, you are adding a positive gamma to a negative delta position on the way up, and then you're subtracting a positive gamma from a negative delta position on the way down. So again, you're getting more and more long as the position goes in your favor, and you're getting less and less long as the position goes against you, or less and less exposure as the position goes against you. That's why buying options is always favorable from a gamma perspective. Selling options has the inverse gamma profile. As the position goes against you, you have increasing exposure. As the position goes in your favor, you have decreasing exposure. Now you might ask, why would anyone want to sell options with such a negative gamma profile? This leads us to our third Greek. The third Greek is called theta. Theta represents the decay in option value for 1 day passage of time. So if you have a position with a negative 12 theta, that means the next day that goes by, holding everything else constant, your option will decay by $12. While option buyers get the benefit of gamma, option sellers get the benefit of theta. A lot of option positioning and option trading is a battle between gamma and theta. But we'll talk about this and gamma scalping in later videos. The fourth Greek, and in many ways the most important one, is called Vega. Vega represents the translation in dollar terms of a 1 point increase or decrease in implied volatility. When you buy options, you are long Vega. You are buying volatility. And you hope that implied volatility increases. When you sell options, you are short Vega and you are short volatility, and you hope that implied volatility decreases. If you own a stock option with a Vega of 0.5 and implied volatility increases 1 point, your option will gain $50 because that's 0.5 times 100 shares for a 1 point increase in implied volatility. It's the opposite for a 1 point decrease in implied volatility. Your option will lose $50 for a 1 point decrease in implied volatility with a Vega of 0.5. What's fascinating about Vega, and more directly implied volatility, is that implied volatility is the only unknown input into the Black-Scholes formula. We'll get into the Black-Scholes formula in later videos, but just to keep in mind that when people buy and sell options, they're buying up or selling down the implied volatility. The fifth Greek is called Rho. Rho tells us the sensitivity of our option position to a 1 point change in interest rates, holding everything else constant. We'll talk more about interest rates and options in later videos. I hope this broad overview on option Greeks was helpful. In later videos, we'll go into more detail on individual Greeks as well as some more complex Greeks. But until then, find edge, capture alpha, and slang signs.